This is what is left of my classroom. It was once a safe place where children came to learn and expand their minds, but now it stands in ruins, like the rest of my country. Then they came, ISIS, and stole the innocence of my children. They told us they were our brothers and they were here to help us. But one by one, I lost the children to their evil cause. The first to be taken was Abbas. All my life, I was just a normal child, with normal hobbies and dreams. I loved playing football with my friend and supported Manchester United. I hoped that one day I could be a football player, but then ISIS arrived. They started coming to my mosque and talked to us about Islam. I began to believe their stories and slowly started to distance myself from my family. I believed in their cause and made the decision to leave my family without telling them. I did not think about the consequences or the impact on them. I thought I was acting in accordance with my religion. They sent me to a camp in Iraq, where they taught us how to fight. If I did not fight, they told me that Shiites would harm my family. We read the Quran a lot, and I slowly realized that I had been tricked into accepting a false version of my religion. The men in the camp behaved un-Islamically. They were killing innocent people. This was not Islam at all. I desperately wanted to escape, but could not find a way out. One day, without warning, they put all the young boys in the truck. We had no idea where we were going. They took us to Mosul. When we arrived, they gave us a choice: fighter or suicide bomber. We were frightened and worried. We knew this wasn't part of our religion, but we were not permitted to refuse. We had all been sentenced to death. I was taken to different safe houses until they decided the time was right for my mission. They were much older to me, but did not care that they were sending a child to his death. I was taken to a Shia mosque and told that to protect my religion, I had to detonate a bomb. As I stepped up to the Shia mosque, I thought about my religion and its true message. I thought about my family and how I had dishonored them. I ran to a policeman outside the mosque and said, "I don't want to kill anyone." I was arrested and taken into custody in Baghdad. One wrong decision has almost ruined my life. I will be released shortly and hope to be reunited with my family. I now hope to use my experiences to stop other children being brainwashed.